Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to discuss about separating colorimeter. So let's see first of all the outlines of the session. Features of separating colorimeter. Then we will see about the principle of separating colorimeter. Next, animation of separating colorimeter. Next, working of separating colorimeter. Next, limitation of separating colorimeter. And at last, application of separating colorimeter. So let's see the first one, feature of separating colorimeter. It is used to measure dryness fraction of the steam or very wet steam. It is very important. Separating colorimeter is suitable to measure the dryness fraction of very wet steam. Now let's see the principle. You know that the dryness fraction of the steam X is equal to MS upon MS plus MW, where MS is the mass of the dry steam in the sample, MW is the mass of the water in sample, and MS plus MW is the total mass of the sample, that is denoted by small m. So if you are capable to find the mass of the steam and mass of the water in the sample of the steam, then definitely you can find the dryness fraction of the steam with the help of this formula. And based on that, the separating colorimeter is designed. So here, first I am going to draw the separating colorimeter step by step. So it is very easy to understand the construction, and you can draw the same thing in the examination also. So this is the outer chamber. And this one is the inner chamber. This one is the pipe from where you can take the sample of the steam. And here the valve is provided. So you can say this is the control valve. And then it is directly connected to the sampling pipe with perforation. That means small holes are provided on the pipe, and that is directly connected to the steam main pipes. So you can say this is main steam pipe from where we want to find the dryness fraction of the steam. Here also the holes are provided, and this inner chamber that is connected with the water level indicator. So this is the water level indicator. Next, the outer chamber that is connected by the pressure gauge. So you can measure the pressure of the steam. One valve is provided at the lower portion, that is called as the stop valve. Now let's see the animation. First, steam is taken from the main steam pipe through the sampling tube, and then it will strike on this perforated cup so that it is collected over here, and this steam having water particles as well as steam particles. It's like that. This green color are the steam particle and these blue colors are the water particles. Now, as you know that the water particles having more density than the steam particle, so that it will be collected at the bottommost portion of the perforated cup. So these water particles are collected at the inner chamber through this perforated cup. And so that gradually the water level is increased. So you can say this is the mass of the water that is actually in sampling steam, and that is measured with the help of this water level indicator. So we can say this is the mass of water. So here you can measure the mass of the water. Now the question is about mass of steam. So look at this figure. Here the green color are the mass of the steam. And you know that mass of the steam having light density compared to the water. So it will reflect like this. And then it will move in this direction. And then it will come out from this annular space in the downward direction, and then it will pass through this pipe with the help of the stop valve. It will send to barrel calorimeter to measure the weight of this mass of steam. So you can find the mass of the steam that is called as the MS. So we can say this is the mass of the steam. So once you got this MW and MS, then definitely you can find the drainage fraction of the steam with the help of this formula. So it is very simple. Now see the working of separating calorimeter. The steam is supplied to calorimeter from the steam main pipe through a sampling tube where it strikes to the perforated cup as we have discussed, and due to the inertia of droplets, water particles are separated and they are collected in the inner chamber. The steam is condensed in the barrel calorimeter where the mass of the steam is measured with the help of the barrel calorimeter. Mass of water droplets is measured with the help of the water level indicator. So very simple. If you are able to measure the MS and MW, then definitely you can find the drainage fraction of the steam with the help of this formula. Now the limitation of the separating calorimeter. It is used for very wet steam only. It gives approximate value because X is always greater than actual due to incomplete separation of the water over here in the perforated cup, because of some water particles can move with the particles of the steam also. Now the application of the separating calorimeter. It is used to measure drainage fraction of very wet steam only. If it is very dry, then once again it will not give you the perfect result. Put your valuable feedback in the comment box for motivating me to make more videos. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video.